Welcome friends. Today we are going to talk about tests for linear regression model. Introduction. In the last session, we had talked about types of data, population regression function, sample regression function, and least square principle, and developed two variables, simple linear regression equation. In this session, we will talk about various tests for linear regression model. In last talk, we had developed regression equation yi cap is equal to 1.1296 plus 0.4838 xi from the sample data. In this talk, we want to test or check whether the regression model is appropriate or not. And if found appropriate, then how to find confidence interval for regression coefficient and predictive value. 2. Test for appropriateness of regression model. We have estimated the values of beta 1 hat and beta 2 hat and developed the regression equation. Now, we need to check that the regression line is good fitted or not. If the residue around the lines are as small as possible, then we can say that the line is good fitted. We can test this using analysis of variance and R square. Total variation in y can be expressed as total sum of square TSS and can be defined as TSS is equal to summation running from I is equal to 1 to n yi minus y bar the whole square. By adding and subtracting yi cap, we get summation yi minus yi cap plus yi cap minus y bar the whole square. And summation yi minus y bar the whole square is equal to summation yi minus yi cap the whole square plus summation yi cap minus y bar the whole square, since the covariance of yi minus yi cap and yi cap minus y bar is equal to 0, where summation yi minus y bar the whole square is equals to sum of square of deviation of original values from mean, that is total sum of square TSS. Summation yi cap minus y bar the whole square is equal to sum of square of deviation of predicted values from mean, that is equals to explained sum of square ESS, and summation yi minus yi cap the whole square is equal to sum of square of deviation of original values from predicted value. This equals to residue sum of square or RSS is equals to summation EI square. Thus, total sum of square TSS is equal to explained sum of square ESS plus residue sum of square RSS, that is TSS is equal to ESS plus RSS. Dividing both the sides by TSS is equal to summation yi minus y bar the whole square, we get 1 is equal to summation yi cap minus y bar the whole square upon summation yi minus y bar whole square plus summation yi minus yi cap whole square upon summation yi minus y bar the whole square. This equals to summation yi cap minus y bar whole square upon summation yi minus y bar whole square plus summation ei square upon summation yi minus y bar the whole square, or this can be written as ESS upon TSS plus RSS upon TSS. We define R square as explained sum of square, that is summation yi cap minus y bar the whole square upon total sum of square, that is summation yi minus y bar the whole square. R square is widely used measure of goodness of fit of a regression line. It measures percentage of change in y due to change in x. Properties of R square. It has a non-negative value and 0 is less than or equal to r square is less than or equal to 1. R square nearer to 0 indicates no relationship, and r square closer to 1 represents strong relationship between variables. With reference to the regression model, r square is more meaningful measure than r, because r square explains the variation due to explanatory variable and provides overall measure, while r indicates strength of relationship between two variables. A. Test the regression model using ANOVA. Assuming that the disturbance term ui are normally distributed, the test procedure is given as follows. The null hypothesis is given by H naught r is equal to 0 versus alternate hypothesis H 1 r is not equal to 0, that is, variable x has no influence on variable y, or the model is not appropriate. The test statistics is calculated as f calculated is equal to ESS upon 1 upon RSS upon n minus 2. If f calculated is greater than f table, then at 1 and n minus 2 degree of freedom and at 5% level of significance, we reject H naught. ANOVA table for two variable regression model is given by one source of variation, sum of square, degree of freedom and mean sum of square. Here we have only one source of variable, that is explain sum of square. So, out of total variation, one is explain sum of square and other is error. Now, sum of square is given by summation yi cap minus y bar the whole square is equal to beta 2 cap square into summation xi minus x bar the whole square. It has one degree of freedom because it has only one explained variable, that is x, and mean sum of square is given by SS upon DF, that is summation yi cap minus y bar the whole square upon 1 is equal to summation yi cap minus y bar the whole square. Similarly, error is given by summation ei square. It has n minus 2 degree of freedom, and MSS or mean sum of square is given by summation ei square upon n minus 2. This equals to sigma cap square, and total variation is given by summation yi minus y bar the whole square, and it has n minus 1 degree of freedom. Let us understand ANOVA from the following example. Here x is income and y is expense, and the values are in 1000. X and y values are 4, 3, 7, 5, 3, 2 and so on. Here we want to test the hypothesis that variable x has no effect on variable y, that is, the regression model is not appropriate or r is equal to 0. In this table, first two columns indicate the original values of x and y. Third column gives yi minus y bar, that is, y bar is equal to 5, and for first value of yi 3, we get yi minus y bar is 3 minus 5 is equal to minus 2. Fourth column indicates the square of third column, that is, square of minus 2 is equal to 4. Fifth column indicates predictive value of yi, that is yi cap. It is obtained from regression equation yi cap is equal to 1.1296 plus 0.4838 xi. Sixth column is yi cap minus y bar, that is 3.065 minus 5 is equals to minus 1.935. Seventh column indicates its square, and ith column indicate the error yi minus yi cap, that is 3 minus 3.065 is equal to minus 0.065, and ninth last column indicate square of e, that is square of minus 0.065 is equal to 0.0042, and last row indicate sum of all these columns in the end. Note that 1 summation yi minus y bar and summation yi cap minus y bar are always 0. Sum of deviation from the mean is always 0. 2 summation yi and summation yi cap are always equal, in our case it is 25. 3 summation yi minus y bar the whole square is equals to total sum of square is equals to 30. 4 summation yi cap minus y bar the whole square is explained sum of square is equals to 29.03. 5 summation yi minus yi cap the whole square is residue sum of square is equal to 0.97. By substituting above values in table format, we get explain sum of square summation yi cap minus y bar square is equal to 29.03. It has 1 degree of freedom, and mean sum of square, that is SS upon DF, is equal to 29.03. Similarly, residue is summation yi minus yi cap the whole square is equal to 0.97. It has 3 degree of freedom, and SS upon DF is 0.97 upon 3 is equal to 0.32, and total sum of square is summation yi minus y bar the whole square is equal to 30, and it has n minus 1 is equal to 4 degree of freedom. The table value of f at 5% level of significance and 1/3 degree of freedom is 34.12, that is f calculated is 89.79, which is greater than f table value 34.12. Therefore, h naught is rejected. This means that the variable x has significant effect on the variable y, or the regression model is appropriate for the given data. B, testing the regression model using t-test. We can also test the regression model using t-test. Under the earlier hypothesis, test statistics is given by t calculated is equal to r into under root n minus 2 upon under root 1 minus r square, and if t calculated is greater than t table at n minus 2 degree of freedom and at 5% level of significance, then we reject h naught. For the above example, we can get r square is equal to ESS upon TSS. This is equals to 29.03 upon 30 is equals to 0.9677, and therefore, r is 0.9837, and solving this we get t calculated as 9.4762. Here t calculated, that is 9.4762, is greater than t tabulated, that is 2.353. therefore, h naught is rejected, that is the model is appropriate. Third, expectation and standard error of regression coefficient and error term. We obtain least square estimates beta 1 hat and beta 2 hat from the sample data, and also test the model for that particular sample. But we can draw n number of different samples, and we have n different estimates of beta 1 hat and beta 2 hat. To find the best estimates, we obtain sampling distribution of these estimates and find out accuracy or reliability or precision of this estimate. Standard error measures the precision of an estimate. Standard error is the standard deviation of the sampling distribution of a statistic from its mean in most of the cases. It indicates how accurately sample represents population. Thus, smaller the SE indicates more representative sample. We can also say that as the sample size increases, SE decreases. Thus, SE is inversely proportionate with sample size. SE of OLS estimates beta 1 hat and beta 2 hat can be obtained from variance of beta 1 hat is equal to summation capital X I square upon n into summation small x I square into sigma square, and SE of beta 1 hat is square root of variance of beta 1 hat or is equals to under root summation x I square upon n into summation small x I square into sigma. Similarly, variance of beta 2 hat is equals to sigma square upon summation small x I square. That is, SE of beta 2 hat is square root of variance of beta 2 is equals to sigma upon under root summation small x I square. Sigma square is equals to variance of u I is estimated from sigma cap square, which is given by summation E I square upon n minus 2. An estimate of beta 2 hat is said to be best linear unbiased estimate of beta 2 if 1. It is linear, that is, it is linear function of variable x. 2. It is unbiased, that is, its expected value is equals to its true value, that is, expected beta 2 cap is equal to beta 2. And third, it has minimum variance in all such linear unbiased estimates. 4. Gauss-Markov theorem. Gauss-Markov theorem says that given the assumptions of the classical linear regression model, the least square estimate in the class of unbiased linear estimates has minimum variance, that is, they are best linear unbiased estimate or BLUE. Within the class of linear unbiased estimates of betas, the least square estimate has minimum variance. We can see that from this figure, the outer circle indicates all the estimates. The next circle within that indicates only linear estimates of all the estimates. The innermost circle indicates linear as well as unbiased estimate, but the point indicates least square estimates has minimum variance. 5. Confidence interval and test on population regression coefficients, variance of population disturbance term. A. Confidence interval for regression coefficient. With the normality assumptions of UI, the OLS estimates beta 1 hat and beta 2 hat are also normally distributed. Z is equal to beta 2 hat minus beta 2 upon SE of beta 2 hat. This equals to beta 2 hat minus beta 2 upon sigma into under root summation small x I square. As sigma square is rarely known in practice, replacing sigma square by sigma cap square, that is, by its unbiased estimator, we can use t distribution, as t is equal to beta 2 cap minus beta 2 upon sigma hat into under root summation small x I square with n minus 2 degree of freedom. Hence, 1 minus alpha percentage is equal to 95% confidence interval for beta 2 is given by probability into bracket minus t alpha by 2 is less than t is less than t alpha by 2 bracket over is equal to 1 minus alpha. That is, probability into bracket minus t 0.025 is less than beta 2 cap minus beta 2 upon sigma cap into under root summation small xi square less than t 0.025 bracket over is equal to 0.95, that is probability into bracket beta 2 cap minus t 0.025 into sigma cap upon under root summation small xi square is less than beta 2 is less than beta 2 cap plus t 0.025 into sigma cap upon under root summation small xi square bracket over is equal to 0.95. 95% confidence interval for beta 2 is given by beta 2 is equals to beta 2 hat plus or minus t 0.025 into sigma cap upon under root summation small xi square. Similarly, confidence interval for beta 1 is given by beta 1 is equals to beta 1 hat plus or minus t 0.025 into under root summation capital xi square upon n into summation small xi square into sigma cap. B, confidence interval for sigma square. Under the normality assumptions, the variable n minus 2 sigma cap square upon sigma square follows chi square distribution with n minus 2 degree of freedom, which we denote by chi square. We can use chi square distribution to establish 95% confidence interval for sigma square, and it is given by probability into bracket n minus 2 into sigma cap square upon chi square alpha by 2 is less than or equal to sigma square is less than or equal to n minus 2 into sigma cap square upon chi square 1 minus alpha by 2 bracket over this equals to 1 minus alpha. And 95% confidence interval for sigma square becomes n minus 2 into sigma cap square upon chi square 0.025 to n minus 2 sigma cap square upon chi square 0.975. Now, let us understand calculation of confidence interval by continuing the example. Here, first column indicate income, second column indicate expense, third is x into y, that is 4 into 3, 12. Fourth column indicate x square, square of x values, that is 16. Fifth column is small x, that is x minus x bar, that is 4 minus 8, that is minus 4. The next column is x square, square of minus 4 is 16. The next column is y cap, which is obtained from regression line, and the second last column is y minus y cap, that is 3 minus 3.06, that is minus 0.06, and the last column is 0.0036, square of second last column, and the last row indicates sum of all the titles which is given in the first row. Here y cap is obtained from regression line, yi cap is equal to 1.1296 plus 0.4838 xi, and estimated value of sigma square is given by sigma cap square is equal to summation ei square upon n minus 2 is equals to 0.9633 upon 3, that is equals to 0.3211, and sigma cap is equal to 0.5667. Variance beta 1 hat is equal to summation xi square upon n into summation xi square into sigma square is equals to 444 into 0.3211 upon 5 into 124, this equals to 0.2299, and SE of beta 1 hat is equal to under root summation capital xi square upon n summation small xi square into sigma is equals to under root 444 into 0.3211 upon n into 124, which comes out to 0.4795. Variance of beta 2 cap equals to sigma square upon summation small x I square, which is equals to 0.5667 upon 124 is equals to 0.0046, and SE of beta 2 hat is equals to sigma upon under root summation x I square is equals to 0.5667 upon under root 124 is equals to 0.0676. Now, 95% confidence interval for beta 2 is given by beta 2 is equals to beta 2 cap plus or minus t 0.025 into sigma cap upon under root summation small x I square, where t with n minus 2 is equal to 3 degree of freedom, and from the t table we have t 0.025 is equal to 3.182, beta 2 cap is equals to 0.4838 and sigma cap is equal to 0.5667 and under root summation small x I square is equal to under root 124 is equals 11.1355. Substituting all these values in equation, we have confidence interval for beta 2 equal 0.4838 plus or minus 3.182 into 0.5667 upon 11.1355. So, confidence interval for beta 2 is equals to in the bracket 0.3218 to 0.6457 bracket over. Similarly, by substituting values in the above equation, confidence interval for beta 1 can be obtained as -1.5631 to 3.8223. Confidence interval for sigma square. For above example, we can find 95% confidence interval for population disturbance term sigma square. We have chi square 0.025 is equal to 0.216, chi square 0.975 is equals to 9.35, and summation E I square is equals to 0.97. Therefore, 0.97 upon 9.35 is less than or equal to sigma square is less than or equal to 0.97 upon 0.216. Therefore, the value of sigma square lies in range 0.1037 to 4.4907. 95% confidence interval means in the long run it will cover the true value 95% of time if correct model has been fitted. Sixth, test for regression coefficient. We can use confidence interval to test the significance of the regression coefficient. The test procedure is given as H naught beta 2 is equal to 0, that is true value of the parameter is 0, or variable x and y are independent, versus H 1 beta 2 is not equal to 0, that is true value of the parameter is not 0, or the variable x and y are not independent. If the confidence interval includes the value 0, means true value of the parameter is 0 and accepts the hypothesis, otherwise reject the null hypothesis. In our case, confidence interval of beta 2 cap does not include 0, implies that the H naught true value of the parameter is 0 is rejected, that is beta 2 cap is significant, or independent variable x significantly affect the variable y. 7. confidence interval for prediction value. We can make single value prediction, that is point prediction, and range of value prediction, that is interval prediction. In practice, point prediction is useful only if we provide degree of precision with it, that is the width of the range of values with point prediction. For given value x is equal to x 0, we can predict the value y is equal to y 0. Our aim is to find the confidence interval for y 0. 95% confidence interval for single value y 0 is given by beta 1 hat plus beta 2 hat into capital X 0 plus or minus t 0.025 into sigma into under root 1 plus 1 upon n plus x 0 minus x bar square upon summation x I square. Suppose we want to predict y 0 for given value x 0 is equal to 10. In our example, we have beta 1 hat is equal to 1.1296, beta 2 hat is equal to 0.4838, sigma cap is equal to 0.5667, summation x I square is equal to 124, x bar is equal to 8, n is equal to 5, and t 0.025 is equals to 3.182. Then the 95% confidence interval for y 0 is calculated as 1.1296 plus 0.4838 into 10 plus or minus 3.182 into 0.5667 into under root 1 plus 1 upon 5 plus 10 minus 8 the whole square upon 124. Solving this, we get the range 3.7455 to 8.1897. Sometimes we are interested in predicting the mean value of y 0. Then the 95% confidence interval for E y 0 is given by beta 1 hat plus beta 2 hat x 0 plus or minus t 0.025 into sigma into under root 1 upon n plus x 0 minus x bar square upon summation small x I square. 95% confidence interval for mean value of y 0, that is expected y 0 for x 0 is equal to 10, can be calculated as 5.9676 plus or minus 1.8032 into 0.4820, which comes out to 5.0985 to 6.8367. Summary. In this session, we understand how regression model can be tested using ANOVA and t-test. Standard error and confidence interval for regression coefficient and error terms are explained. Prediction for single value and mean value of y 0 from the regression equation is discussed along with the confidence interval of prediction value. Thank you.